into it. I think we should ditch it. Thank goodness he didn't. Lewis Capaldi is someone you love to hear on London's Heart. You've got me, Zoe, in for JJ and Kelly Brook. Thank you so much for choosing Heart this afternoon. At 4:30, here's the latest.
From Global Newsroom, I'm Holly Jones. The government says it won't hesitate to act if there's a spike in coronavirus cases in London. So after reports travel in and out of the M25 could be restricted, we asked these people in London's Leicester Square if they thought people were following the rules.
I've heard a lot of stories about being on the underground, that people are sitting next to each other.
I work in a bar and we have social distancing, but it's, you know, the more people that do come in, it is harder to maintain.
On the whole, yes, but there are many exceptions.
Greater Manchester, a major incident has been declared after a spike in infections. Says the Transport Secretary says 1 in 10 people using public transport are breaking the rules on compulsory face coverings. 285 penalty notices have been given out since the rules came in. The time it takes to find out if you've got coronavirus is being cut to just 90 minutes. 2 new tests, which will also check for the flu, are being rolled out in the UK next week. Ministers have called it a game changer. DW Sports is going into administration, putting 1,700 jobs at risk. The fitness group's website is already closed, with stores to follow. The lockdown, which saw shops and gyms close, has a big impact on its finances. And lots of restaurants and cafes are offering half-price meals, thanks to extra money from the government. And get £10 off with Eat Out to help out from Mondays to Wednesdays in August. From Global's Newsroom, you're up to date on Heart.
Times are now 4:05. Time for another bit, have we?
Yeah.
Sing that.
It's alright, we got our red torches.